Okay, Alita Battle Angel. This is a movie that I see a lot of interesting conversation on the internet right now about. Like, there's definitely that divide, right? But it's not the normal divide of critics versus everyday moviegoers. This is a debate between those who have seen the original material, have read the manga, and those that have just watched the movie. Mm-hmm. So there's definitely a bit of divide there. Let me just get out of the way and state two things. Sorry for the cat in the background. And two, we have not read the original manga. So we're coming into this fresh, like we don't have any context or anything. You know, it's just us watching a movie. Mm-hmm. And in that sense, what did you think was a thing the movie did right?
Well, so for number one, the combat of this movie is outstanding.
It's dope.
Especially with James Cameron being the producer, you mm-hmm. get that high-tech CGI that just really connects with everything that's going on. You don't get lost in it. You are able to follow everything that's going on with these high-tech cybernetics.
Focus.
Yeah. And it helps so much with the combat. You get to see combat through different forms. Like, you get to see it in a roller derby kind of game. You know, you see that in the trailer. And that comes out really cool. You know, they're going everywhere in the city. You know, it's awesome.
I never knew I wanted Whippet to be cybernized.
Yeah.
Yeah. But you got that. It was dope. Like, Ellen Page, come on, come in here.
Where are you at?
Be against the leader. I wanted to see that movie.
So that is my positive. What about you, Anthony?
Okay, so positive. I definitely think there were two characters, and only two, we're going to go into that in a minute, that worked really well together in this movie. Christoph Waltz was good. I was afraid there'd be like the crazy Christoph Waltz looking at the meteor, you know, that we got in the Spectre, right? I was a little afraid that we'd get that Christoph Waltz. But he actually brings it down. He takes it down a notch, and he becomes this really interesting and layered father figure for Alita, which really, really works. So, real good there. And jointly, Rosa Salazar works really well as Alita. This, you know, amazing, really interesting, crazy cool cybernetic warrior, essentially.
Yeah.
And you don't realize that she is the way that she is until, you know, 10-ish minutes into the movie, where you really get a sense that, oh yeah, my memory's gone. Oh yeah, I gotta figure this out. First, you know, they establish the father-daughter dynamic, works really well, and then they add on to it. And even in the add-on segments, it works really well. And I think Rosa Salazar 100% was committed to this role, which is a lot to say because some of her lines were really, really corny. And her character manages to just skate away from it, just barely. Now, the only bad thing is not everyone else escaped that fate.
Yeah.
So, segue, bad.
Yes. So, when you talk about doing adaptations of manga into a Western live-action movie, ideas kind of get lost.
Translation.
Yeah. So, a really nice, you know, idea of, you know, like, giving your heart to someone in a manga might come off as very, very corny in a Western live-action movie. And it really does. It does not go well. And there's a lot of this. There's a lot of dialogue in this that if you put it into an anime, it would fit really well, you know, because anime is weird. It's weird like that. But you get a lot of symbolism that you're able to show in that.
And that's the anything where you're trying to, like, make a live action, you know, movie or something. Yeah,
yeah.
It comes with a sense of down-to-earthness that I don't think the movie quite gets.
Yeah. And, yeah, a lot of that symbolism is hard to show in a live-action movie. And so when you get these dialogue moments, you're just like, ah, why is that in there? That feels uncomfortable.
Really?
Really uncomfortable.
And what's up with randomly making people like, I'm your bitch now, and like wearing sexy clothing, and then I'm bad, but then I have a heart, and then I'm not wearing sexy clothing. It's really annoying. Sorry.
Yeah. But a lot of dialogue is bad, and that really affects characters. Anthony would like to give you a very tight rant as to what character really went wrong in this.
Mahershala Ali is one of the best actors in freaking Hollywood right now. He's so good, and he is totally wasted in this movie. His character is nothing but a pawn, simply put. And every single time he's like, I am in control, I do the thing. But then like 2 seconds later, he's admitting that he's a pawn of Nova. And then Nova straight up, every like, you know, time that he speaks, like 2 minutes later, has a moment where he's like, I'm controlling you. And it's like really annoying. It's really annoying, and his eyes change, and that's goofy. Another thing about translation, right? It doesn't work. And, like, it just sucks because Mahershala Ali should be the Nova. He should be the guy that's controlling everything, and yet he's just a puppet, plain and simple, and, you know, he gets tossed aside in that manner. And maybe that was the point, but I don't like it, I don't dig it, and I honestly, again, think it's a shame because he's so amazing.
And it does that classic Western trope of henchmen where they act they act all macho, but then once they encounter the
super bad guy gets revealed.
Yeah, once they encounter the protagonist, they're all wimpy, and you know, it just it goes all downhill and
so fast.
And especially with someone like Mahershala Ali, who is able to get into such deep characters.
Yes. He's emotional.
Yeah.
And it's like, it's not even there. Yeah. It's not even there.
And
you can see
he's trying.
Yeah, he really does.
I see you, Mahershala.
It's not his fault.
Yeah.
It's just bad writing ultimately is the thing that kills this movie, in general.
Yeah.
We can put it that way. So if I had to rate this movie, I would probably throw it in the six-ish category. Like,
yeah.
I've always said, and I gotta stick by my guns when I say this, as cool as the action is, and I'm almost tempted to be like, ooh, just go see it for that, I can't, because ultimately, what do I always say? If it's gonna be a good movie, you need to set up the action properly first in order for those moments to super, like, resonate, and for it all to become this conjointed, really beautiful experience.
Yeah.
It's sequel baits, it doesn't quite live up to it, and I gotta give it a 6 for that.
Yeah.
You know?
What
would you rate it?
I too would give it a 6. While I know that not everyone is like us, and a lot of people are out to see a movie that's going to be entertaining. And if you are one of those people, you're definitely gonna be entertained by this. There's a lot in here to just like look at the combat and see how cool it is.
It also wasn't all white people.
Yeah,
that bonus.
And there's enough of a plot to follow, so you don't get bored with the story.
Absolutely.
But if you are like us and want to see a movie really live up to its source material, which I don't know if it does, but as far as its elements of, you know, having a deeper meaning, it doesn't have that. And it just gets tiring when it tries to.
Yeah, exactly. That's exactly it. It's tiring, right? It's vexing. So yeah, ultimately, I would definitely say wait on it. I don't think it's worthy of a watch immediately. For those of you that are interested and you want to check it out, I'd say save your bucks. Go watch something else right now.
Yeah, you know,
you got tons of Oscar bait movies right now.
Yeah, yeah. Definitely go see those if you haven't seen it yet.
Yeah, which we need to do.
This is our review of a alright movie.
Yeah! So, thank you guys for watching said review of an alright movie. And hey, if you're interested in other better movies, go and check our YouTube out. Go and check our Facebook out. We just did a review on Broly. That was super fun. Yes. That's a worthy watch for sure. If you're not a DBZ fan, in my opinion. So, yeah. Stay tuned here for more as always. And we're going to go watch this Broly, I think.
Oh, yeah? Definitely.